Hello friends, I am Nilima. Once again, welcome to our channel about technology. Today in this video, we will discuss about UDP, User Datagram Protocol. I have already made a video on TCP, Transmission Control Protocol. You can watch that video from the link given in the description. So let's get started. After watching this video, you guys would be able to know what is an UDP and why it is required, queuing in UDP, multiplexing and demultiplexing in UDP, limitations and advantage of UDP. The User Datagram Protocol, UDP, is the simplest transport layer communication protocol available of the TCP/IP protocol suite. It involves minimum amount of communication mechanism. UDP is said to be an unreliable transport protocol, but it uses IP services, which provides best effort delivery mechanism. In UDP, the receiver does not generate an acknowledgement of packet received, and in turn, the sender does not wait for any acknowledgement of packet sent. This shortcoming makes this protocol unreliable as well as easier on processing. Now, why do we need an unreliable protocol to transport the data? We deploy UDP where the acknowledgement packets share significant amount of bandwidth along with the actual data. For example, it can be implemented in case of video streaming, where acknowledging thousands of packets at a time is troublesome and wastes lot of bandwidth, and loss of few packets in video and video traffic couldn't create much impact and can be ignored. It is a connectionless protocol where each datagram is independent with other datagram. There is no connection establishment and termination. Ordered delivery of data is not guaranteed. As user datagram are not numbered, it is suitable for the data flowing in a direction. It cannot send a stream of data. Instead, each request must be small enough to fit into one user datagram. It is a stateless as it doesn't send any acknowledgement messages. In UDP protocol, the protocol numbers are used to distinguish the processes running on server and client side. We know that UDP provides process-to-process communication. Client generates the process that needs services, while server generates processes that provides services. Queues are open for server and client processes. Two queues for each process. Incoming queues, which receive messages, and outgoing queues, which send messages. The queues functions as long as the process is running. And when the process is terminated, the queues are destroyed. UDP handles the sending and receiving of UDP packets with the help of the following components, such as input module, input queues, control block module, control block table, output module. Input module receives a user datagram from the IP and searches the control block table to find an entry having same port as this user datagram. If it is found, the module uses information in the entry to enqueue the data. Control block table keep a track of open ports. Control block module manages the control block table. The UDP package uses a set of input queues for each process. Then at last, output module creates and sends user datagram. Several processes may want to use the services of UDP. UDP multiplexes and demultiplexes to handle this, so that multiple processes can run on a single host. Now let's discuss the limitations and advantage of UDP. UDP provides an unreliable connection delivery service. It does not add anything to the services of IP, except for providing process-to-process communication instead of host-to-host communication. UDP message can be lost, duplicated, delayed, and can be out of order. UDP doesn't provide reliable stream transport service. There is no flow control mechanism, and there is no acknowledgement for received packets. However, it does provide error control to some extent. And the advantage of UDP is that it produces minimum number of overheads. So guys, that's all for today. Thank you for watching. In the next video, we will compare TCP and UDP protocols. Please like, review and share the video, and don't forget to subscribe our channel.